Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I will be talking on important topic of surface characterization. Generally, surface of a solid can be characterized by two ways. One is spectroscopy and second is microscopy. So today I will be talking on electron spectroscopy. Generally, electron spectroscopy is a study of power of electron as a function of energy or wavelength or wave numbers. So in electron spectroscopy, there are three techniques. One is XPS, that is X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy. Second is Auger electron spectroscopy. And third is UPS, that is ultraviolet photoelectron spectroscopy. So today I'll be talking on only XPS, X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy. Introduction of XPS. The technique of XPS is also known as electron spectroscopy for chemical analysis, ESCA. X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy is a type of electron spectroscopy. It is a function of electrons or power of electrons, number of electrons which is emitted from the sample surface as a function of energy. It is an analytical technique to study the electronic structure and its dynamics in atoms and molecule. XPS was invented by Kai Sigvan in 1954. And for that, he received a Nobel Prize in 1981. He worked in Uppsala University, Angstrom Laboratory. In XPS, primary beam is X-ray photons, which are irradiated on sample surface. The secondary beam is electron, obtained, then analyzed. The secondary beam is made up of electrons. The spectrum of XPS consists of plot of number of electrons or power of electrons emitted from the sample surface as a function of energy, that is kinetic energy or binding energy. Now the principle of XPS. The principle of XPS is based on Einstein photoelectric effect. Due to the bombardment of X-ray photon on the sample surface, the inner core shell or inner shells, that is K and L electron, are ejected, which are further analyzed by the analyzer. Let us consider EB prime and EB double prime are a binding energy of lower energy levels of inner core orbitals, while EV prime and EV double prime are the energies of valence shell electrons. The monochromatic X-ray photon, that is H nu, when incident on the sample surface, the inner shell electron abstract the energy from this X-ray photon and get ejected in terms of energy, kinetic energy of the ejected electron is recorded by the spectrometer, and it is given by the equation kinetic energy is equal to H nu minus binding energy minus phi. So from this equation, it is clear that monochromatic source is required for the instrument. In XPS, two electrons are required. Therefore, XPS is not useful for the determination of hydrogen helium. Now here, EK is kinetic energy of the ejected electron. H nu is the energy associated with incident photon. EB is binding energy of ejected electron. And phi is the work function of the instrument. There are some questions, basic questions, based on introduction and principle of XPS. First question is, what is the fundamental difference between electron spectroscopy and other types of spectroscopy? Answer is, in electron spectroscopy, the kinetic energy of emitted electrons is recorded. And the spectrum consists of plot of number of electrons as a function of energy or frequency or wavelength of the emitted electrons. Second question is very important question. Why XPS is also known as ESCA? XPS is also known as ESCA because in contrast to UPS and AES, UPS and AES both are electron spectroscopy. The XPS provides not only the information about atomic composition of a sample, but also the information about the structure and oxidation state of the compounds. Therefore, XPS is known as a ESCA. Binding energy, defined binding energy. Binding energy is defined as the attraction between the electrons and atomic nucleus. Next part of XPS is instrumentation. Here you can see the instrument and their components. Source is X-ray tube, then sample holder, crystal disperser which select the X-ray photons of known energy, and then it incident on the sample surface, and then electron goes through the hemispherical analyzer to detector, and finally spectrum is obtained in a signal processor. And we'll discuss one by one the part of instrument. The electron spectrometer made up of following components, or these are the major components of XPS. First is source, then sample holder, analyzer, detector, and signal processor and readout. First, source. The simplest X-ray photon source for XPS is X-ray tube, which is equipped with magnesium or aluminium metal target. The kinetic energy of aluminium is greater than the magnesium. The monochromator crystal can also provide X-ray beam having bandwidth of 0.3 electron volt, which provides much smaller spots on the sample surface to be examined. Second component is sample holder. Sample holder is located in between the source and entrance slit of the spectrometer. The crystal disperser, which is present on the Rowland circle, which select the photons of known energy from the source and incident on the sample surface. The area inside the sample holder should be evacuated with 10 raised to minus 5 torr pressure to avoid the contamination of the sample surface. And the gases sample are introduced into the sample compartment through a slit to provide a pressure of 10 raised to minus 12 torr. If pressure is higher, then attenuation of electron beam may take place. And if the pressure is lower, weaker signal may be obtained. So generally in sample holder, high pressure is required in XPS. Third is analyzer. Analyzer is a hemispherical in shape with very high electrostatic field is applied on the analyzer. The pressure inside the analyzer is 10 raised to minus 5 torr. When electron enters into the hemispherical analyzer, it travels in curved path, and radius of curvature depends upon the magnitude of field and kinetic energy of electron. The detector. In XPS, detector is electron channel multiplier tube or transducer. When a single electron passes through the electron channel multiplier tube, it gets converted into number of electrons or pulses of electrons, that is 10 raised to 6, 10 raised to 8 electrons. Here you can see in a diagram. When a single electron passes through the glass tube, which is coated with the vanadium and lead metal atom, when a single electron passes through the electron channel multiplier tube, it gets converted into number of electrons or power of electrons, pulses of electrons, that is 10 raised to 6 to 10 raised to 8 electrons. And then finally, signal processor and readout. The function of signal processor is to amplify the signals and readout device converts signals into the spectrum, XPS spectrum. Now, applications of XPS or ESCA. There are various applications of XPS. Identification of active sites, determination of surface contaminations on semiconductors, study of oxide layers, analysis of dust on sample surface, oxidation state determination. All the elements of periodic table can be determined or identified except hydrogen and helium, as they do not emit inner core electron. Another applications of qualitative analysis. The XPS spectrum having a kinetic range 250 to 1500 electron volt and binding energy is 1250 electron volt to 0 electron volt. Every element in the periodic table is having one or more energy level in this range. So elements present in the sample can be identified from their binding energy. Now here you can see two graphs. One is for kinetic energy and one is for binding energy. The scale is number of electron or power of electron as a function of energy, kinetic energy or binding energy. So next application is chemical shift. If one of the peak in XPS spectrum is studied under high energy resolution, then it is observed that position of the peak depend upon the chemical environment around the atom which is responsible for the peak, that is number of valence electron and types of bond affect the position of peak. If the oxidation state increases, binding energy increases and peak position shifts according to increasing binding energy. Then chemical structure. Ethyl trifluoroacetate. The example ethyl trifluoroacetate, the XPS spectrum of carbon of ethyl trifluoroacetate. So this x-space of this sample shows 4 peaks due to 4 carbon atoms. The first carbon atom shows peaks towards high binding energy. You can see in the graph. Due to the 3 fluorine atoms, 3 fluorine atoms are attached to first carbon atom, which is having higher binding energy. The binding energy of second carbon atom is slightly lower than first carbon atom because fluorine is more negative than oxygen atom. Third carbon atom is having binding energy higher than fourth carbon atom because third carbon atom is attached with one of the oxygen atom of acetate ion. Therefore, binding energy decreases from first to fourth carbon atom. Then advantages of XPS. It is a surface sensitive technique. Wide range of solid surface sample can be identified, and it is relatively non-destructive technique. Disadvantages of XPS. It is very expensive, slow and poor resolution power, and it requires high vacuum. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.